As you can see, I've just took a grab a bike from my hostel to the Dalat Railway Station, which I'm glad I did, to be honest, because it would have been quite a walk. He didn't really wait, he gave me a helmet and then just sped off, so I was basically just holding the helmet on top of my head. Anyway, here it is, it's very beautiful. This was built between 1932 and 1938, you can see the French colonial style. I'm hoping to get the steam train to a little town that's 7 kilometres away, where they have a quite an unusual pagoda. The station's pretty beautiful from what I remember. Wow, look at this. This has not changed at all. I've managed to get here great time, because this train actually leaves in 10 minutes and the next one after that is in another 2 hours. You can't actually buy a ticket for this train and come back on a train in a few hours time. You have to come back immediately, which is just insane. So I'm not really got time. The train's already up and running. A little bit fast. I would have liked to have had a bit more time here. It's actually a shame that I've only got a few minutes, because I would have liked to just hang out here and maybe have a lovely coffee in the train cafe. This train leaves in like 6 minutes.
This is the VIP one section.
To the some of the Dalat strawberry farms. And it looks like we're pulling into Trai Mat train station. Well, watch my head here. So I'm not going to get the train back, because I'd have to leave in like half an hour, and I want to go and see this pagoda, because it's quite special. It's made up of like 12,000 glass bottles. Before I do that, I need coffee and food. That's the coffee situation sorted. I'm hoping to get a banh mi, because the entrance is just here. The Mung Zuan Di La. This is not actually the temple. I think this is stuff that you can buy. I think this is a shop, or maybe I'm wrong. Yeah, so all this stuff is actually for sale. Bit of shopping in Dalat. Wow, just look at this place. It's incredible. 12,000 bottles were used to make these pagodas. I'm not sure which one's the original one, because as you can see, there's quite a few. There's a huge Buddha there. We'll get a closer look at that in a second. All right, let's take a look inside then. Thank you. This is probably the best view of this pagoda over here. Well, according to Wikipedia, the dragon in here is 49 meters long. Can't see it being that long, to be honest. Oh, who knows? Well, this is the tail. Okay, so it goes right underneath there. Right, I guess it's time to climb this beast then. So to get right to the top, you have to take this spiral staircase. Still not at the top. Maybe one more to go. I thought this would be the final floor, but it still keeps going up. It's getting steeper and smaller now. I think this is going to be the last one. Wow, check this out. Whoa, that's incredible. The whole of this part of the temple is surrounded by Buddhas, even on the second and third floors. And then you get this huge one in the middle. That's just amazing. How beautiful is this temple? These guys always freak me out. When you go to like Madame Tussauds and you see the waxworks, and they're terrible, aren't they? And yet you come to a temple and they're so lifelike. The last thing I'm going to look at is a place that a lot of people who come here actually miss, because it's not really signposted that well, and it's tucked away at the back of the main kind of six-tier pagoda. This is hell. This is not the place I was thinking of. This is just another shop. Now this is what I mean about the hell part of this pagoda being hard to find, because I am in the right place and you basically have to come down them stairs that I just come down, and then you come into this big huge, well, store really, isn't it? You still might miss it because tucked away in the corner, this is the entrance. The entrance to hell. I wonder how many people, tourists, come all the way to this pagoda and miss this part. Experience. What a strange thing to find in a place like this, underneath a pagoda, a Buddhist temple. And there were lots of Vietnamese families by now, and the little kids were terrified, and the parents were just deliberately scaring the shit out of them. I think our little journey to hell is a good place to finish. What an incredible place, and it's free to get in. The whole complex, all of it's free, which is really cool. From here, it's like a 1.5 hour walk back to Dalat. There are buses, but I don't know how often they are. I don't know if they stop at anywhere to pick you up. I presume they do. They normally do in this part of the world. And so I've got a choice now, because if I walk, I actually move away from the main road. Or do I just wait here and hope that a bus will stop and pick me up? A bus will take about 15 minutes. Ugh. I could do with some food, but I've run out of options. It looks like we're getting to the end of Trai Mat, I think it's called, this place. So I'm going to give it 10 minutes, see if a bus turns up. Well, a guy just pulled up on his bike and said, "Excuse me, sir, how can I help you?" He had someone on the back, so I knew he wasn't just trying to give me a ride. But I asked him if the bus would pick me up here to take me to the centre of Dalat, and he said, "Yeah, no problem." He said it'll be in about 30 minutes, which I didn't like the sound of, because I thought they were every 30 minutes, so anyway. Apparently it will pick me up. Whenever it turns up. A bus has just gone past. I don't know if that was the local bus, there were people on it. It said Dalat on the back, which was a great bloody help. Now if that was a local bus, that means I got another half an hour to wait for another one. And that might drive past as well. I've just searched for the name of the bus company and it's quite far away. So maybe that was like a bus that you have to book in advance. It didn't look like the bus that I saw coming in. They were like kind of green, old battered things. So I don't bloody know what to do. And now our van's parked up, meaning I can't even see what traffic's coming. Although it looks like he's just picking up some potatoes, so we shouldn't be there too long. Not easy getting about in Vietnam. It's easy to get long distance journeys, but to get from one little town to the next, there's just no information online at all. I reckon I've easily been sat here half an hour now. There's been like buses go past, but they don't look like the local bus that I think I'm waiting for. I ain't got a clue. I don't want to leave, because the second I bloody get up and leave, it'll fucking turn up. Still not eating anything. Is this it? Please, this be it. Got that? No? I ain't got a clue what to do now. I'm thinking, shall I walk back to the train station and get the train back? That's going to be more expensive, obviously. And I don't even know if you can get one-way tickets from here. That would mean walking back into the city, and if I can't, that means I've got even further to walk. It's a bloody nightmare. I decided to walk back to the train station and just hope that I can buy a one-way ticket back to Dalat, because this bus has just not bloody turned up. Absolute joke. I was hoping I might see it on the way back, but it doesn't appear to be the case. What's this here? This is a bus to Dalat. We got it. No idea where the bus like dropped you off. I mean, I've got off here, which is maybe like 5-10 minutes walk away from the lake. I think the bus station, yeah, he's turning off up that way, so I got off at the right place anyway. Now we need to find some bloody food. Oh, so the bus has basically dropped me just a couple of minutes away from the supermarket that I was in yesterday. Now I know I can get some cheap, crappy takeaway food from here, which on the one hand is not ideal, but on the other hand it's pretty good because it means I can just buy some food that's going to fill the hole and then later on treat myself to some bloody good Vietnamese food. My last meal in Dalat. It's time to sit down and enjoy these snacks from the bakery. Let's see what we've got. Fluorescent slice of pizza, and I don't even know what that is. It's probably cheese as well, to be honest. I was hoping it was going to be sweet, but I ain't got a clue. Right, time to stuff this in me gob.